Very good evening. Today I wish to give you some information regarding the popular varieties of crop plants that is released by the public sector unit. So in the first part I will give you information regarding that agricultural crops. The second part I will try to provide you information regarding that horticulture and other crops. So in that the first one is NRC 109, that is a soybean variety. In the case of soybean, variety of products are available for consumption purpose, starting from milk, tofu and other products are there. And the major problem with reference to that soybean product is concerned, the presence of that off flavor, so that make that people somewhat unpleasant with reference to consumption of the soybean product. So in order to overcome that particular problem, Indian Institute of Soybean Research, IISR, Indore, they develop a soybean variety that is totally free of that lipoxinase 2, that is LOX2 free soybean. So because of that LOX2 free, that a product made out of that soybean is have a very good flavor and aroma also very good. So because of that, these particular variety is very much suitable for preparation of the soya milk and tofu and other products. Because of all these advantages, and that IISR Indore also end up a MOU with Nature Bio Foods Limited, New Delhi, as well as that Sonic Biochem Extraction Limited, Indore, for commercialization of these particular variety. So that is a NRC 109 soybean variety. This particular variety totally free of that lipoxinase 2. And then another three varieties. These varieties are related to the cotton. The main advantage of these particular varieties concerns a genetically modified cotton variety. This have the CRY1AC gene that give a resistance against that bollworm. So whatever that varieties, whatever that material, PT cotton material developed by the private sector under, it's a hybrid, it's not a variety. But PAUPT1, that is Punjab Agriculture University, they develop a PT1 and FN861. Another one variety, that is RS2013, that particular variety also a genetically modified cotton variety, that one also have that CRY1AC gene. That particular variety is developed by the Rajasthan Agriculture University, Bikaner. In that, PAUPT1 is the first genetically modified PT variety. Because of this variety nature, the farmers also kept it. They no need to go for that changing of that seed material every time. They can reuse that material. That is the main advantage of these particular varieties. Among the three genetically modified cotton variety, in the PAUPT1 was completely developed by the Punjab Agriculture University. The another variety of that PAU, that is a FN861, as well as that Rajasthan Agriculture University, Bikaner, that is RS2013, and those two materials are developed with the help of that Central Institute for Cotton Research, Nagpur. All the three things are variety conferred resistance against bollworm that carry the gene of CRY1AC. Then in the case of rice, that Pusa Basmati 1121, this is a very wonderful material. This make India to get more foreign exchange through export of this material. For the year 2018-19, the foreign export earning by the way of exporting these Pusa Basmati 1121 alone, somewhere around 32,805 crores. And also this particular variety is developed by the Cuttack Rice Research Institute. And this particular variety that cover that area of 18% to 20% of the rice area is under the cultivation of Pusa Basmati 1121. So every year this generate a gross value of 48,000 crores. And Pusa Basmati 112, it's a EDV, that is essentially derived variety. So this particular variety is developed from already available variety. That already available variety is the initial variety. That initial variety was upgraded, and they developed that Pusa Basmati 1121. And these also developed by adapting that long process of that hybridizations. And that variety also developed by the Vijay Pal Singh and his student Ashok Kumar Sariel. So this particular rice variety is known for its extraordinary kernel length. So the length is 8.4 millimeter. That individual grain length is 8.4 millimeter. In terms of inches, that is 0.33 inches. So this is the longest ever known released cultivar in the world. So Pusa Basmati 1121 is the longest ever known released cultivar in the world. And it's have a very high kernel elongation ratio also, that is ranges from 2 to 2.5. that is elongation ratio is the ratio, that is ratio between the length of the cooked rice kernel / length of the uncooked kernel. So the elongation ratio is 2 to 2.5. and after cooking also, this is totally a non-sticky one. So this is developed by the IARI. It's an important export commodity as far as India is concerned. So Pusa Basmati occupies 70% of the export share. So it's a very income generative. So the year 2009, through this, the India got 5,000 crores. But by the year 2014-15, and by the way, exporting these material, India earned 27,597.87 crores. So this is a very good export commodity as far as that India point of view. That is a Pusa Basmati 1121. Then another variety, that is a sugarcane variety, that is a CO0238, otherwise called it as a current 4. So this also a really very good material. This material is a high yielding and high sugar content variety. This is derived from COLK8102 cross CO775. This particular variety is developed by the Sugarcane Breeding Institute Regional Center, Kernel, early maturing type, mainly released for commercial cultivation in the Northwest Zone. During the year 2015-16, in one milling mill that is located in Sitapur district of UP, there this particular material recorded highest sugar recovery of 12.1%. So this is the highest sugar recovery, which is the highest ever recorded in subtropical India. So that is a main advantage of this one. So CO0238 is a high sugar recovery of 12.1%. Another thing is, this is a reversal of the trend. So that is the demand of a subtropical sugarcane variety in tropical India. So even though this material is developed for subtropical India, the tropical part of that India also, they are making a demand for this CO0238. This is the first time in the history of the sugarcane industry in the country. So that is a demand of a subtropical sugarcane variety in tropical India. This is observed for the first time in the history of the sugarcane industry in the India. Then some of the rice varieties. So these varieties are CR Dawn 801, or otherwise called it as IET 25667. Similarly, that another variety CR Dawn 802, or otherwise called it as Subhas IET 25673. So these variety developed by the National Rice Research Institute, Cuttack, and also this is mainly developed from the popular variety Swarna. So this is a climate smart varieties, because these two variety have a submergence tolerance as well as that drought tolerance. That submergence tolerance is conferred by the sub 1 gene, whereas that drought tolerance is governed by QDTY1.1 and QTTY2.1 gene. These two genes are responsible for drought tolerance in the case of CR Dawn 801 and CR Dawn 802. And also these varieties developed by following marker assisted Pycross breeding program. So outcome of the marker assisted Pycross breeding program, these two varieties are weakly photosensitive nature. So CR Dawn 801 and CR Dawn 802, these two are climate smart varieties. So both the variety have a resistance to submergence tolerance as well as that drought. Then in row of that previous two variety, another two variety, that is CR Dawn 310 and CR Dawn 311. These two varieties are high protein rich varieties. So particularly CR Dawn 310, that is the first biopodified high protein variety that contain protein of 10.2%. This also developed by the Katak. And CR Dhan 311, or otherwise called as a Mughal, this also have a high protein of 10.1. And in addition to protein, this also have a moderately high zinc, that is 20 ppm content. So that CR Dhan 310 and CR Dhan 311, it's a protein enriched material. You can easily remember these two variety name by remembering these particular thing. So CR Dhan, you can make it as a CR Dhan, like that. The last year we had a World Cup match that is held at London. So whenever the match begin, the match begin at the time of that 3:10 p.m. So by the way, remembering these incidents, you can easily remember and recollect. So that CR Dhan, CR Dhan, it's opening batsman. It's a boosty man, muscle power also more. So it's a high protein person, like that you can easily remember. CR Dhan 310, CR Dhan 311. So CR Dhan, you can make it as CR Dhan. The time is 310. So in that way you can remember. So CR Dhan 310 and CR Dhan 311, these two are high protein varieties. And then another two variety, chickpea. These two variety also have its own advantage. The first one is a Pusa chickpea 10216, that another one is Super Anigiri 1. Both the things are developed by adapting that technique of genomics assisted breeding. So this is the first material developed by adapting that genomic assisted breeding. And Pusa PGM 10216 developed by the IARA in collaboration with ICRISAT. Pusa chickpea 10216 is developed by the IARA in collaboration with ICRISAT. So actually Pusa 372, it's already popular variety, but it have its drawback of that drought intolerance. So by the way of infusing that gene available in the ICC 4958, actually ICC 4958 is a local land races that have the drought tolerant characters. That gene was transferred to Pusa 372. So by that way they developed that Pusa 10216. So now that Pusa 10216 that conferred drought resistance. And also that Pusa 1026 is the first variety to have a drought tolerance through molecular breeding. Just they develop within 4 years period of time. So developed by the IRA in collaboration with ICRISAT. Similarly, that Super Anigiri, that variety also developed by the US Raichur in collaboration with ICRISAT. Super Anigiri 1, otherwise called as MABCWRSA1. So this particular variety have a fusarium wilt resistant character. Actually that Anigiri 1 is a local variety, very popular, but the problem of that particular thing is susceptible to fusarium. So the Anigiri, through this molecular breeding approach, the Anigiri 1 was upgraded by the way of transferring the gene from WR315. It's a chickpea land races that have that fusarium resistant gene. That gene was transferred to the Anigiri 1. By that way they developed that Super Anigiri 1. So that Super Anigiri 1 is resistant to fusarium wilt. So developed by the US Raichur in collaboration with ICRISAT. Both Super Anigiri 1 as well as that Pusa 10216 are Tesi type. And the chickpea project is the first ICRI project among the pulse crop to identify molecular breeding products for commercial release in India. So this is the advantage of these particular varieties. And then HT3226 or Pusa Yasavi, it's a wheat variety. This variety also developed by the IRA. So this is very well known for its high yielding and high protein character. That Pusa Yasavi, it's known for its high yielding potential as well as protein content. That genetic yield potential is 79.6 quintals. This is much higher than the other known varieties. And also that Pusa Yasavi has a higher content of zinc, protein and gluten. So because of a higher amount of zinc, protein, gluten, so this is a more of strength and elasticity for the tuff will be there. And also this is highly resistant to all major rust fungi, starting from yellow or striped rust or brown or leaf rust or black or stem rust. So this is a very good material yield wise, quality wise, and disease resistant wise. That another two variety in groundnut, and that is a Girnar 4 ICGV15083 and Girnar 5 ICGV15090. So these two varieties are first high oleic acid groundnut variety developed by the ICAR, Directorate of Groundnut Research, Junagadh. So these two varieties are known for high oleic acid content. The kernel have oleic acid content of about 80%, 80% of the total fat content, whereas that other variety have only 40 to 50%. Alone is a oleic acid among the total fat content, whereas here Girnar 4 and Girnar 5 that contain oleic acid content of 80% of the total fat content. So because of high oleic acid content, it have less low density lipoprotein, that is a bad cholesterol, whereas this have a high density lipoprotein, that good cholesterol. So because of that, by the way of consuming these groundnut, we can maintain the healthiness of our system. Then another wheat variety, that is Karan Vandana, or otherwise DPW187. So this particular variety is released for irrigated timely sown condition of the northeast plains. So irrigated timely sown condition of the northeast plains, and also this confer resistance to leaf rust and leaf blight. So this will come to flowering within 77 days and mature 120 days after sowing. So this will recorded the yield of 640.70 quintal, and petra chapati making variety. So petra chapati making variety and high iron content, that is 43.1 ppm of iron is there. Okay, high chapati making and high iron content is add and value of these particular Karan Vandana. It's a wheat variety. So these are all the things with reference to that some of the rice, wheat, cotton and sugarcane variety. So the next class we can I can provide you some more information regarding that popular varieties in the remaining crops. With that, we are completing these particular sessions. Thank you.